Hi, Scott Holewinski here from Gillware Data Recovery, and today I wanted to walk you guys through what's a really important tool for us to maintain industry-leading success rates here at Gillware. And that's the tool that you're looking at right now. It's what we call our glide and burnishing tool. And what it allows us to do is clean up the surface of the very delicate magnetic media prior to actually doing our data recovery work. This is actually the inside of a hard drive. Some folks might not be familiar with what it looks like inside a drive. And the basic components are pretty simple. Right here is what we call the hard drive platter. This is where the data is actually stored. These are the read-write heads, and they kind of move like the arm on a record player as this platter spins. And this is what actually reads and writes the data to the platter. In normal operation, these heads, which are very, very tiny, right at the very end of that armature, actually float just above the surface of the platter. Now, a very common situation that we get here at Gillware is sometimes those heads crash, or they actually contact the platter surface. And when that happens, they actually cause all kinds of microscopic debris that actually ends up embedding in the platter. So before we can do our data recovery work, we actually have to clean that debris up before we replace those failed heads and perform the actual recovery. And that's what this tool actually allows us to do. It allows us to see, first off, how dirty the platter is, and secondly, it actually allows us to clean that debris up. So I'm actually going to walk through how this actually all works. So the first thing I'm going to do, this is actually a test platter. And let me just say that in normal operation, I would have on full headgear and a lab coat, but for purposes of this video, it's a little hard to do a presentation with all that on. So I'm just using gloves, but this is a test platter. It's a laptop platter. And the first thing I'm going to do is what we call a glide. And the glide test, anytime it encounters debris, is actually going to record that encounter, that hit, so that we know, first off, how dirty the platter is. So I'm going to go ahead and set that up first. So the first thing that's going to happen is it's going to clamp the platter down, and this is spinning at about 15,000 RPM, so it's spinning extremely fast. Now on the screen here, you can see that it's going to be recording all the little dirt and debris and hits that it gets or that it encounters. Every time that glide head deflects, it records that hit here on the screen. So as you can see, there's quite a bit of debris in this particular area, and as the platter spins, it's being spun outwardly. And that's the debris that we're going to look to clean up with the burnishing process. And it's almost complete. And there we go. So the glide test, again, gives us an indication of how much dirt and debris is actually on the platter. So I'm actually going to take a screenshot of this so we have something for comparison after we do the burnish to see how well we did. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do now is to actually burnish the platter and try and clean it. The burnishing head, much like the head inside the hard drive, is not going to actually contact the surface. It's going to float just above the surface, maybe a couple nanometers above the surface, and essentially shear off any dirt or embedded particles in the platter. So I'm going to go ahead and set up that burnishing process. Now that was pretty dirty, so I'm actually going to do a multi-pass burnish. Now when we get drives in that have been in fires or floods and they're extremely dirty, maybe they've been in sandy water, in those situations we may run 20 or 30 or 40 passes of the burnishing head before we actually get it clean. So I have this set up and I'm going to go ahead and click start. And now the burnishing arm is going to encounter the platter. And again, it's going to make multiple passes in an attempt to clean up the dirt and debris that was on this platter. So I think I have this set up for a multi-pass of maybe 10 to 20 passes. And the thing we're going to do when we're all done is we're actually going to go back, re-glide it, and we'll see how well we did with this burnishing process. I would like to note, we get this device, this burnishing and glide fixture is exactly what they use in the manufacturing facilities of Seagate and Western Digital and the like. We had one retrofitted for us so that we could have it here in our data recovery lab. It's all pneumatic. This spindle motor that you see here, like I said, it's spinning extremely fast, but it's an air bearing, so there's almost zero vibration in this apparatus, and that's critical so we don't do any further damage to the platter. Sometimes this process is really fast. Other times, like I said, we have to do multiple passes in order to get it clean. So at this point, the burnish is finished. And like I said, the last thing we want to do is see how well we did. So we're going to re-glide it one more time. So I'm going to go and do that right now. And it may not be perfect. Like I said, sometimes this takes multiple passes, but we'll see if it's at least better than it was last time. You can see it's still getting hits. And here's some fairly significant damage. So this is likely going to require multiple passes of the burnishing in order to get it clean. But we'll go ahead and do a comparison to see how well we did. So this is after burnish, and if we go back to the picture before burnish, you can see that there's definitely extra hits that were occurring in this particular area that have been cleaned up slightly. This is something that we encounter a lot. Sometimes, like I said, it takes multiple passes, and when you talk about the cost of data recovery, why does it cost what it costs? It's because situations like this where we need to go back, redo work multiple times in order to actually perform the recovery work. So again, this is just a glimpse into some of the tools that we use here at Gillware to do our work. Very, very critical component of our data recovery process. Hope you enjoyed the insight, and feel free to contact Gillware anytime for more information about our data recovery services. Thank you.